So today I wanted to talk about memory. And when we talk about computers, often we ask the question of how much memory does your computer have? And really that's kind of a confusing question because really there are kind of two main kinds of memory we talk about. We talk about the hard drive and we talk about the RAM. Not so bad, right? So when we talk about these two different types of memory, we got to keep a couple of things in mind. One is the hard drive tends to be much larger, is more capacity, than RAM. And RAM, so hard drive is a lot more capacity, but RAM is faster. So why do we have these two kinds of memory in our computer? When we talk about computers, we can say the CPU is in this box over here, right? And then all of our stuff that's stored on our computer, including the operating system, is on our hard drive over here. Not so bad, right? Now, the hard drive is where we store all of our stuff. And it's slow because in a conventional hard drive, there's actually a disk. It's really kind of cool. You've got a disk that spins very rapidly, and you've got this arm that comes over the disk with a little detector on it, and that detector can swivel back and forth. And as the disk spins, the detector swivels back and forth, and it finds the pieces of information we need. And that motion takes time. And then it's got to feed that into the RAM, which is kind of our working memory. Now, RAM is faster than the hard drive, all right? And one of the things to realize, though, with the RAM is often called volatile memory. It's volatile memory because it actually goes away unless there's power going into the computer. The hard drive memory is non-volatile. That means it sticks around. So the RAM is kind of our working space. It's where we're storing all of the stuff while we're working on it. And when we're done, we put it back away in the hard drive. And when we need it again, we get it out of the hard drive. Now, one of the things you can often do to speed up your computer is buy more RAM. More RAM is almost never a bad thing. One of the reasons it can speed up your computer is because sometimes when you're working on files that might be really huge, like video files or images, those files may be larger than your working space, which is your RAM. And so what happens is your RAM does this kind of cool thing. Your operating system does this kind of cool thing where it carves out a piece of the hard drive and it uses what we call virtual RAM. So it's not real RAM, it's virtual RAM. And so a piece of your hard drive storage space is reserved for this virtual RAM. And so sometimes some of the tasks, it has to go all the way back to the hard drive to be working on it when it really should be just saving that right in your RAM and that speeding things up, making things go faster. So often more RAM will speed up your computer because it removes the need for that virtual RAM piece which is on the hard drive, and the hard drive is slower. Not so bad, right? Now, there's another thing that we need to keep in mind, and that's that the CPU can only do one thing at a time. And how does it keep track of what it's doing? So we've got actually a couple levels of cache. We call them L1 and we have L2, and now people are starting to talk about L3, and L3 would go in here. These are cache, and when we say cache, we mean C-A-C-H-E, not dollar sign, all right? So when we're talking about cache, it's C-A-C-H-E, and it's a place to, again, store stuff. And so, and I guess this is where we're really working on the stuff. So I always like to think of an analogy where we're thinking about, if I'm a chef, I might be in a kitchen, and in the cupboards and in the refrigerator is all of my ingredients. That's my hard drive space, but I'm not working with all of my ingredients all the time because maybe I'm making creme brulee and I don't need all of my ingredients. So my RAM would be like my countertop, and right? It's my countertop. And so I could be prepping a whole bunch of stuff on my countertop. And me, as the chef, I'm the CPU. Now, my cache, my L2 cache, might be my stovetop where I'm actually doing the work. It can only hold so much stuff. There's only four burners, and really, I'm only focusing on one of those burners at a time, but that could be like my cache. Make sense? So there's a lot of different ways to think about how computers do stuff, but it basically works that way. So the hard drive feeds stuff to the RAM feeds it to the cache, and the cache is what the CPU is doing. And then it also goes back the other way, right? Because the CPU has to store stuff back into RAM, and that stuff in RAM has to get stored back to your hard drive. Pretty cool, right? So this is a little bit about how your computer uses memory. And this is CS50X DCHS.